Black people, we have been yelling from the mountaintops for years, but it seems as if it fell on deaf ears. My name is Emmanuel Acho, former NFL athlete, current NFL analyst, and also the host and creator of Uncomfortable Conversations with a Black Man. 2016, Colin Kaepernick, he decides to sit down during the national anthem, not take a knee. Then a man by the name of Nate Boyer, a former Green Beret in the U.S. military, and said, "Hey Cap, it would be more respectful for those who have previously served if you took a knee instead of sitting down during the anthem." Now the agenda has been moved that Colin Kaepernick is disrespecting the American flag, when in all honesty, Colin Kaepernick is taking a knee to protest police brutality, racial inequality, systemic injustice, etc. And Colin Kaepernick, he loses his job shortly thereafter. Okay, fast forward, 2018, the NFL and Roger Goodell, they mandate that every player must stand during the national anthem. June 2020, the world, America's in turmoil again, a racial divide. Roger Goodell, the NFL, they put out a cautious statement. And for the first time since I've been playing and watching the NFL, I saw the players band together in a manner I've never seen before.
We, the National Football League,
condemn racism and the systematic oppression of black people.
They released a video saying, "Hey, Roger Goodell, who's the commissioner of the NFL, this is what we black players need to hear from you to know that we have your support." And to my shock, Roger Goodell releases another video essentially saying exactly what the players wanted to hear from him.
"We, the National Football League, condemn racism and the systematic oppression of black people."
So it'll be very interesting and telling to see what players do during the anthem and what Goodell follows up doing. I don't just want to see the NFL throw money to black communities. That's not what I want to see. I want to see genuine holding of hands and walking through this process together.